The heat is all gone, the wind has turned to chill. But before we can lock the shed doors, one more race and embrace the spirit, the bluster, the crew, the shell, and the oars. So under the colours of autumn and martyr, we push ourselves up to the start, where warm-up and prayer and confidence bolster the mind, legs, torso, and heart. Oh, how we persuaded ourselves and our crewmates that we had trained enough. But before the first beach had gone past our blades, our lungs are sounding rough. Then the strain starts a coming, and coxswains are brimming with tactics and technique and lies. We're definitely flying, the others are dying. Now sit back and drive down those lungs. There's a big moment coming, the crowd are humming. It's a mental respite from the burn. But check traffic, check steering, check landmarks, stop veering. It's crucial, of course, it's week's turn. We've all seen the pictures, the film clips, the paintings of carnage, the shipwrecks, the action of race plans and winners. If coxes misjudge the week's line by just a bare fraction. But we're through. Raise a cheer and the rating, the course is abating. We've more than half this thing done. Then straight through the pain comes the simple refrain. Was this race not supposed to be fun? Here the river is wider. There's a gap in the trees. Take care lest the eight sideways blow. Wipe the sweat from your eyes and hold your head still. Stare sternwards and ask, has that gap grown? The crew's there, your opponents, all vying to rob you of medals, of titles and more. But rowing's not warfare. They're more friends than foe there. You'll share beer and a handshake ashore. At Cambridge, the announcers will call you past their dock, saying more words than any human should. So row long for the webcast, and for once be in time, so that the commemorative photos will look good. The last stretch is crucial, and painful, and drags. Whatever you've given, find more. At the line, you'll want the feeling, whilst your head is reeling, that you absolutely could have given more. So before ice shuts the river, and the city battens down, and the winds from the north make their snarls, head up, breathe deep, drive the legs 10 more times, and a toast to the head of the Charles. Yeah.